Hello everyone, welcome to yet another video tutorial of WebEpic channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how to add and configure price with tags into product feed. As usual, we'll be using CTX Feed, a WooCommerce product feed generator plugin. So without further ado, let's start the video. So I'm at my WordPress website right now. First of all, you have to go to WooCommerce settings. And then you have to look for this portion right here, default customer location. And you have to make sure this default customer location sets to shop base address. If the option is anything else other than shop based address, then your price with tags might not work properly. So it won't calculate your price with tags later on. So you might want to make sure this option default customer location stays in shop based address. Now I'll go to CTX feed. Let's just create a new feed here. So I'm creating a totally new feed for this video. Let's just make the country United States for the sake of this video. Make the template as custom template 1. I'm making the file name as price with text. Feed type XML. I guess I'm good to go here. For this video, I'll be only needing ID and title. And the rest of the attributes, I don't need only for this video. So I'm deleting all the attributes and I'm only keeping my custom attributes ID and title. And for adding and configuring price with tags, I'll be needing to add some custom attributes. So let's just go with 4 new attributes. And I'm naming my custom attributes. First one as regular price. Let's make it sale price. The third one, I'm making it as regular price with tax. Let's make this sale price with tax. Sale price with tax. So for my each and every custom attributes, I'll be needing some product attributes as well. So for regular price, I'm making my product attribute as regular price. For sale price, I'm making my product attribute as price. For regular price with tags, I'm making my product attribute as regular price with tags. And for sale price with tags, I'm making my product attribute price with tags. So I have to map all these custom attributes with my product attributes. So after mapping all these custom attributes with my product attributes, I have to update and generate my feed here. So I'm updating and generating my feed. So my feed is generated successfully. Now if I go to the XML file, you can see all of my product which I've already created before. Regular price and sale price with and without tax is showing in the XML file. For example, the stove's regular price is showing 150, sale price is showing 120. And remember, you have to configure the tax. Without configuring the tax, you won't get the result. You won't get the increasing price of taxation. Like $150 became $165 after taxation, $120 became $132 after taxation, and in terms of soap, $10 became $11, and for caps, $80 became $88, for sale price, $60 became $66. So it's calculating 10% of tax on each and every product. It's continuing the same way throughout this whole XML file. Like if you talk about t-shirt, fabrics, if you talk about suit, belt, every single one of them, they're calculating the tax automatically. So this is how you get to add and configure price with tax into product feed. That's all for today's video. Thank you for watching.